2023 has been the year of Troye Sivan. He got us back to the dance floor with his chart-topping album Something to Give Each Other, stole the show in The Idol, and even introduced us to his very sexy alter ego. Good times keep coming, with November serving up Troye's first ever Grammy nominations and a whopping 4 ARIA awards. Troye Sivan!
Troye Sivan,
yeah.
We're backstage at the ARIAS. You have just swept the night. How do you feel?
Oh, I don't know. You're the first person I've spoken to since it all happened. So, I'm really, really happy. This is so meaningful to me. This is Australia and Australian music. It's just like such a huge part of who I am, and everyone in America probably gets really, really tired of hearing me talk about Australia and how much I love it here and how much like this is home to me. So yeah, to be here and to be getting the awards is really, really cool.
And all of the awards, just getting all of the awards.
get all the awards, yeah, that's awesome.
I have to say, talking about the party, that the love in the room for you tonight was palpable. Like, you must have felt that energy every single time your name was announced, which was many times. This country has genuinely embraced you as like one of the, you know, one of their sons, one of those beautiful humans. Did you feel that?
Definitely, yeah. And I think, I don't know, it's crazy. I started traveling when I was really young. I also wasn't born here. So for me, the sort of like acceptance and love, I feel so Australian.
But also, is there anything more Australian than someone not being born here in the country saying, oh yeah, he's ours now?
Totally.
Yeah,
exactly. And so I'm really, really, it feels really nice to feel that, love tonight.
When you have such a successful album, does it make you want to take more creative risks, or do you just feel like, oh, I've got the formula, I want to stick to this?
No, it makes me want to take more risks, because that was what we did this time. It was just like whatever felt right, and we were trying things and we were playing, and it was like, it's such a safe space to just do what we loved. We did not think for a second about how any of it was going to be received or anything like that. We were just making stuff that we loved that felt right.
Yeah.
This album is all about connection and joy and dancing and, you know, and love, and it has to be fun. And so it was so fun to make the album.
Yeah.
It was so fun to make the videos. And that's really what I want to keep up.
I have to talk to you about the music videos, because obviously they're amazing.
Thank you. So many
spectacular juicy butts, if I'm being honest. Like,
yeah.
I would say the highest ratio of excellent butts of any music video ever.
At least in Australian music.
At least in Australian music,
yeah,
there has to be. Talk to me about how Ross Lynch got involved.
Wow, so I just knew, you know, the song specifically was about the dream guy, you know, that everyone loves, including myself. And so I was like, I need the internet's boyfriend. Like, who is the internet's boyfriend? And
I think you might be the internet's boyfriend.
No, not in the same way that he is.
Okay.
It's like every couple of weeks, I feel like he trends on Twitter just for being like the internet's boyfriend
and
for being like the hottest guy alive. But I, you know, it's a big ask. So I was like, you know, I'm going to be in drag, sort of like giving you a lap dance. Is that going to be okay? And he was like, bro, first of all, I'm in full drag.
Yeah.
And he calls me bro, and I'm like, looking so fit. And he was like, do whatever you want. I feel totally comfortable with everything. And he was an absolute legend. So it was a really good time. Everybody wants you, babe.
I cannot let you go without talking to you about Timothée Chalamet. Like, when you think about this year, what's the standout achievement between nominated for a Grammy alongside Kylie Minogue and Timothée Chalamet plays you on Saturday Night Live?
It's me, Troye Sivan. Let's go!
I think it's both of those, because it was over the same weekend, and I just think that I will never forget that weekend for the rest of my life.
When did you find out about the sketch?
Saturday Night Live has asked to clear Got Me Started.
Okay.
So I knew that they wanted to use the song, but I didn't know for what. And then I Googled it, and I was like, who's the host? And it is Timothee. And I was like, there's no way. And then I just watched it live with everyone. And I thought maybe it'd be like a quick moment if I was lucky or something, but it's this full sketch, and it's awesome. So yeah, it was great.
Do you feel like there could be the opportunity for a collab, like he's in a music video?
Well, no, I just need to impersonate him now.
100%.
Yeah.
When you think back on tonight, what memory are you gonna hold closest to your heart?
Probably my dad's face, I think, when he was like pushing people away to give me a hug when I won, I think it was Best Solo Artist. his face like screwed up in a way that I've never seen before. So yeah, it was cool and scary.
That's awesome.
Yeah.